Windows Deployment Services, WDS, Part 2 of 3. Hello everyone, in this video we'll see how we can add a boot image which is required to boot a Pixie client, and we'll also see how we can add an install image which contains all the files that are required to install a Windows operating system on a Pixie client. We'll also look at the Pixie response and Pixie boot policy, which defines how your WDS server is going to respond to your Pixie clients when they communicate with the WDS server. And we'll also look at disabling the VMware DHCP service if you are running your WDS setup on a VMware virtual environment. And we'll also look at DHCP scope options that are available if your WDS and DHCP servers are running on the same server or if they're running on different servers. And finally, we'll install an operating system on a Pixie client using WDS. Now, for the successful network-based installation of Windows operating system using WDS, you must add at least one boot image and one install images. So what are boot images? So boot images are Windows PE images that can be used to boot a Pixie client computer to deploy an operating system. So if you go into the installation media of a newer operating system, you should be able to see boot.wim in sources folder. So this boot.wim contains Windows PE and Windows Deployment Services client. So let me open up the WDS console and let me show you how you can add the boot.wim image. Under servers, when you expand WDS server, you'll see boot images. And if you right click on it, you'll get an option that says add boot image. So I'll click on it and I'll browse the location where I have my boot image. So that'll be my installation media, and I'll go into sources and I'll select boot.wim. I'll click open and I'll click next, and here you can specify an image name or description, and you can also see the image architecture, which is 64-bit. So I'm going to click next, and here you can review the summary and click next, and now it's adding the boot image. All right, the selected boot image has been successfully added to the WDS server, so I'm going to click Finish, and now you can see the boot image that has been added, and you can see its architecture, status, size, and you can see that the boot image size is smaller than the size of the actual Windows image. So this is how you add a boot image. You can also add additional boot images if you would like to. So after adding the boot image, now we can go ahead and add an install image. So install images are the operating system images that you deploy to the client computer. So let me go back into WDS. And if I go back here to my installation media of the Windows operating system, under sources, I should be able to see install.wim. So this is my install image. So I'm going to go back into WDS console, and I'll right click on install image and I'll click on add install image. Since I've inserted Windows Server 2012 R2 ISO file, I'm going to name this image group as Windows Server 2012 R2, and I'll click next. I'm going to browse the location of my install image, and I'll click open and I'll click next. Now you'll get an option to select the different editions of Windows Server 2012 R2. I'll only select the Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center edition with the GUI. If you're okay with the default name and description, you'll leave this option checked and click next. Otherwise, you can uncheck this option. It says use the default name and description for each of the selected images and click next. Now you'll get an option to type a name for the install image we are adding. For the image name, I will type Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center GUI. I'll type the same name for the image description, and you can see the image architecture, which is 64-bit, and I'm going to click Next. Now you can review the summary and click Next to add the install image. All right, you can see that the install image has been added successfully, so I'll click Finish. So this is how you add an install image. You can also add additional install images if you'd like to. Now, before we start deploying the Windows operating system to Pixi clients, we need to configure the Pixi response and Pixi boot policy. So let me go back into my WDS server. And if I right-click on my WDS server and go into Properties, I can see the Pixi response tab. I'll click on that. You can see various Pixi response policies, which I've already discussed in part one of this video series, so you can go back and watch that video to understand what these different options means. But there's one little option that we can set, which is Pixi response delay, which specifies how quick your WDS server respond to your Pixi client. So the default is 0 seconds, and we are okay with that. The next Pixi policy is the Pixi boot policy. Here, for your known computers and unknown computers, you specify how your Pixi clients communicate with WDS server. You can specify whether the user needs to press the F12 key to continue the Pixi boot, or should it always continue the Pixi boot, or if the Pixi boot should cancel if escape key is pressed, or you can set the Pixi boot to never continue. You can also specify the default boot image, which is optional. You can specify different boot images for each type of architecture, such as x86, x64, IA64, ARM processors, x86 with UEFI, and also x86 with UEFI architectures. Another thing that you need to take care is to disable VMware DHCP service on your host system. So if you are running VMware Workstation and if your WDS setup is actually set up virtual machines on top of VMware Workstations, then you need to disable VMware DHCP service. Otherwise, if you don't disable the VMware DHCP service on your host system, then while you try to install an operating system, you'll get this error when the Windows setup is about to start. So I've disabled VMware DHCP service in my case. Now there are a couple of things that you need to make sure when it comes setting up your WDS and DHCP scope options. We'll try to understand this using a couple of scenarios. So scenario one, WDS service and DHCP service are running on different servers, but your WDS server, DHCP server, and your Pixi clients are all on the same subnet. If you have this kind of setup, you'll not run into any problems. So as long as the WDS server, your DHCP server, and your Pixi clients are on the same subnet, you don't need to configure anything on the DHCP scope. Pixi clients will automatically get the boot and install images from the WDS server without any problem. Scenario number two, WDS service and DHCP service are running on different servers, but your WDS server, DHCP server, and your Pixi clients are not in the same subnet. So here, the broadcasting would be a problem across different subnets in most environment. So what you need to do is you need to configure a few DHCP scope options, option 66 and option 67. So you can get these options if you go into properties of the scope options used for Pixi boot. So when you click Advanced tab, you'll see option 66 and option 67. So option 66, it will specify the WDS server host name, and option 67, it will specify the boot file name that the Pixi clients will use to boot. So for 32-bit, you'll say boot x86preboot.com, and for 64-bit clients, you'll say boot x64preboot.com. Now, there is one more scenario, which is WDS and DHCP are running on the same server. So if you have this kind of setup, so you must tell WDS to not listen to UDP port 67, leaving it available for DHCP traffic only. But you may wonder how Pixie client will find the WDS server. For Pixie clients to find the WDS server, you need to set option 60 in DHCP scope. So if you install WDS on a server that is already running DHCP service, then during the configuration of WDS, the DHCP option 60 page will appear. And you can select both do not listen on DHCP ports and configure DHCP options to indicate that this is also a Pixie server. If you have already installed WDS and if you want to reconfigure it, you can go into the properties of WDS server and you'll find the DHCP tab where you can set these options. And if you install DHCP service on a machine that already has WDS installed, you must manually enable option 60 in DHCP. So to do that, you go into properties of the scope options used for Pixie boot, and under general or advanced, you'll see option 60. All right, now we are good to install an operating system on a Pixie client using WDS. So what we are going to do is we are going to install Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center Edition, which we have just added as an install image. All right, I'm going to power on my Pixie client, and it's going to do a Pixie boot. I need to press F12 to do a Pixie boot. You can see that it's loading the files. All right, you can see the Windows setup where it says Windows Deployment Services. You can select the locale, which is English United States. In my case, I'm going to select English India. And the keyboard or input method is also English India, so I'm going to click Next. Now I need to enter the administrator credentials to connect to my Windows deployment server. All right, so since we have only one install image, which is Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center, we're going to select that and click Next. From here on, it's the same setup process that we follow for any type of Windows installation. So this is how you're going to deploy a Windows image to a Pixie client using WDS. In the next part of this video series, we are going to talk about some of the advanced options which are available in WDS server. So thanks for watching this video. For more videos, please subscribe to my channel.